Thank God for today. We bless His name and we thank Him also for the gift of life. Today I want to share with you something about prayer. I know you've been reading it always, but I want to just emphasize on something and be specific on something about prayer. We've been praying always, but sometimes we need to get some few understanding about some things. And what I'm talking about, I entitled it Wrestling in Prayer. Wrestling in Prayer. This is what many people or some pastors call it, spiritual warfare. Spiritual warfare, that means in prayer. And so I read from the book of Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12. It says, "For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in heavenly places." So Bible is telling us that we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against principalities, powers, rulers, and wicked host of wickedness in heavenly places. And when it talks about heavenly places, sometimes you may think that where God abodes, but then it's just like in the firmament or in the atmosphere, they rule and they do a lot of battle with us. Now, the word wrestle, I just want to explain simply, wrestle means to fight somebody, especially as a sport, which we all know. In other words, by holding them and trying to throw or force the person to ground or to the ground. We all know wrestling. Wrestling, that is all that it means. You hold the person tight and you make sure the person goes down. You don't want to sort of, you know, give the person the opportunity or chance to put you down. So when I'm talking about wrestling prayer, then by now you should understand what I mean. In other words, we wrestle in prayer and not just to allow the enemy to put us down. But we are supposed to make sure we hold fast our faith and our trust in the Lord and everything and make sure we bring our enemy down. For prayer, we know that it's just a communication between you and God. And so sometimes we think that the prayer is only talking to God, and which makes it simple for us that maybe just talking, God, I need this, your requests, petitions, so and so. But I believe that if you're talking about wrestling in prayer, it means that prayer is not just only asking God, give me this, protect me, and do that and do that. But it also means engaging in spiritual warfare. Engaging in spiritual warfare, because it is through prayer you do wrestle in the spirit. So it is also a type of something we use to engage in warfare, which is spiritual warfare. And so we don't just look at prayer that is simple, like just telling God, I need this, protect me, do this and do this. At times in prayer, you must engage yourself in a wrestling, in a battle, or in a warfare. It is out of that you are able to overcome things, because some of the things we talk about, they are not just simple things. And when we are talking about some of these principalities and powers, and sometimes we think that, what are we talking about? We are talking about the fact that our enemies are invisible. In other words, they are unseen. So we are not in a conflict with flesh and blood, like human beings or physical abilities of men, but against spiritual forces. They are stronger than flesh and blood. They sometimes, or maybe I will say, they see us, but you do not see him, or you don't see any spiritual forces physically, unless God opens your eyes. And sometimes when we're talking about, people get confused. What do you mean? Can something spiritual you don't see happen and you is affecting you and influencing your life and changing things in your life? Yes, that is why the Bible says that God is also a spirit. You don't see God physically, but you believe he is there. So these are the things we have to understand. And for me to let it become very simple for you to understand when we're talking about spiritual, and what I'm talking about is the fact that we all know what we are in now. Our president keep on saying that we are fighting one common enemy. This is an enemy virus you don't see with your physical eyes, but sometimes we are afraid of it. And so that is why when we say we wrestle in the spirit it means. Many believers have belittled this aspect of prayer, and so we look at it that it's not necessary. Those two who also know how to do battle in the spirit, they also find it difficult to do it. Sometimes it's because it is not easy to do a spiritual warfare. But I believe that a believer who know what is called spiritual warfare and engage himself from time to time in it, the believer will be able to break through certain resistance the enemy will bring on his or her way. So it's very important for us to look at it from this point of view. We don't just have to look at it that, oh, what are they talking about? Are they talking about things where somebody cannot see and you say we are doing it? That is it. But it is important for us to go to God in that. And I want you to know that God wants us to be strong. Learn to engage in spiritual warfare and He will help us to win those battles. It is not something so difficult. It is just normal thing that you've been doing. But except that you don't focus, or maybe sometimes your attention has not been drawn to that area. But I believe it's very important because it is time for us to pray, and we need to keep on praying and pray and pray till we win. There are certain things we are not just going to have them easy. The enemy will hold it and the enemy will struggle with the answers, just as it happened to Daniel. But we need to continue to pray and do the spiritual warfare so that we'll overcome it. And so then the question then is that, what warfare it is? Is it this wrestling? What kind of warfare? You have to know this wrestling. It is important for you to know this wrestling. Now, in the book of 2 Corinthians, Paul says something, chapter 10, verse 1 to 4. He said, "Now I, Paul, myself, am pleading with you by the meekness and gentleness of Christ, who in presence am lowly among you, but being absent, am bold toward you. But I beg you that when I am present, I may not be bold with that confidence by which I intend to be bold against some." Look at it. "Who think of us if we walk according to the flesh? For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God for pulling down strongholds." So it means that there is something we need to do. For the Ephesians, it talks about the spiritual warfare, the wrestling, and then told us we have to put on the armor so that we can do the battle. And the armors are not just simple thing or physical thing, but they are spiritual things we do, the word of God, and etc., etc. But here Paul is also telling us that sometimes some of us think that because we walk in the flesh, we eat in the flesh, we see in the flesh, we do everything in the flesh, our weapon as a Christians, we are also doing everything in the flesh. No, we don't do everything in the flesh. We learn to understand that everything is not flesh. So we do it in the spirit. And so Paul was also reminding the church in Corinth that they should understand that some of them think that we are walking in the flesh, we are doing everything in the flesh, so our warfare is in the flesh. Our battle is not in the flesh. And so he said that our weapon too is not carnal. Carnal simply means that it's not flesh, but it's not in the flesh. So that whatever we do spiritually, as far as Christians are concerned and will be praying, we learn to understand the spiritual principle. Not only praying and thinking that we are doing praying only in the physical and all that. Let's focus also in the spiritual. So we should know the warfare or the wrestling. You cannot go and wrestle with somebody physically without knowing the person. And all the wrestlers learn to know their opponent. And so we need to know what kind of wrestling we are in. And so quickly, I want to just show you some few things or say some few points about the wrestling. The first thing I want to say is that the wrestling or warfare is not flesh and blood, just as the Bible has said. We are not engaged in flesh and blood warfare. Our wrestling is not flesh and blood, just like physically we see on television and all that. No, that is not it. Ours is different. Two, this wrestling ground, it is against unseen forces. Unseen forces. They are spiritual, so that is why you don't see them. Yeah, it's against unseen forces. And that is somehow, sometimes it makes the thing very difficult. because you are a carnal person or you are a physical person and you are fighting with somebody or wrestling with somebody who is not physical. So sometimes even assessing your strength and knowing what to do is much difficult for us. But I believe that God has also given us the energy and the strength for us to overcome. Except that sometimes we don't want to see it that way and accept it that way. But if you accept it and understand that there are unseen forces, then you also know what to do. And because they are unseen forces, Paul makes us understand another point number three about the wrestling ground or what we are engaged in. Our weapons are spiritual. In other words, they are not carnal. They are not physical. So if you understand that you are engaged in a wrestle which is not flesh and blood, and then it means that it's unseen thing, it's spiritual, then he said that we should also look at the weapon, because they may be using certain weapon you have no idea. So you have to get your weapon as an unseen weapon, spiritual weapon, and we need to do that. It is important for us to learn how to do this wrestling. So how to do wrestling is important. That is what I'm going to talk about and take time with it. Because most of us, we believe that certain things that happen to us, it has a spiritual background, but we don't even know what to do. It is something we know, this one, there's a spirit behind it, but we don't even know what to do. We can do this wrestling, and God has always been with us, and we will win the battle. So the first thing I want to say about how you go into this wrestling is that the first thing you should remember is you do it through prayer. I call the prayer as our channel or the way by which you do this wrestling. It's just like natural wrestling where you cannot just get up and wrestle outside and do it anyway. You go and you go with a strength, you have a channel, you know what to do. That is our spiritual way. So the prayers we pray, it is not only for asking God, do this for me, do this for me, do this for me, and just thanking God. Sometimes it's a form of engaging in a battle, and it's a wrestling. You wrestle with the enemy in the spiritual world, you wrestle with the enemy with your prayer, and you speak and say that this is what I want it to be done. As I said earlier, you learn how to hold the person and bring the person down, naturally, natural wrestling. And so spiritually, through your words, by the word of God, by what you are saying from your mouth in the form of prayer, you tell the enemy, I want you to do this. You tell the enemy, I will not accept this. You tell the enemy, this is what I want. And it is through prayer. It is through prayer that you can get into this wrestling. You can't just sit down and be eating and say, I will just get into the wrestling. The enemy is fighting you and you are not fighting. You learn to do that in prayer. The second thing I want to say, which is very, very important, is that you learn to allow God to teach you how to do battle. To teach you how to do battle. Spiritual battles are not done by our own intellectual ideas. No, they are done by spiritual understanding. And it's God who is a good person or good teacher who can teach us how to do this battle. And so Psalm 144 verse 1 says something. He said, blessed be the Lord, my rock, who trains my hands for war and my fingers for battle. So it means that God sometimes will train your hands to do war. It is not always that things comes your way and you just relax and say that this thing, it does not matter to me. I don't care what will happen. No, God will train your hands for battle. He will train you to do war. Why? Because he will help you to overcome. Psalm 18 verse 31 also say that it is God who arms me with strength and makes my way perfect. So why will God arm you with strength? The word arms means that it's very important. Okay, he arms you with what? Strength. To do what? Just to sit down? No, to do battle. And so we are in a time where we need to do strong battle. We need to focus on certain things and go ahead and do it. Whatever comes your way, if you sense that it's a spiritual battle, don't just sit down and take it for granted. Do it with prayer and God will help you. The same Psalm 18 verse 34 says that it is God who arms me with strength It is, he said, he teaches my hands to make war so that my arms can bend a bow of bronze. So you see Psalm 18, 31 and 34 is telling us that he teaches us. God teaches us to make war. And so sometimes God has a way of telling you that this is a battle, you must fight it. And so don't take just spiritual things and leave it like that and allow the enemy to just ride on you. God trains you. He will train you. He will arm you. He will strengthen you and make sure that you do that battle and then overcome that battle. The next thing I want to say is that in doing this battle, you learn to hold on to God's word. It's very important. Hold on to God's word. What I mean is that keep the word of God with you. Learn to read the word of God. Learn to study the word of God. Let the word of God get into you. Know exactly what God's word is saying concerning the situation and you, your position, what you can do. It is by the word of God you will know well who you are in Christ Jesus. Then and then when you say you are doing spiritual warfare, you will not be afraid. You are confident that God is with you. He says he trains your hands to do battle. So it gives you, the word of God will give you firm ground to do wrestling. Why do I say that? Because in wrestling, if naturally, if you don't have a ground, they will put you down. So spiritually, you need something to stand on it. The word of God will strengthen you, will ground you well, will give you firm ground so that you will be able to do this battle spiritually. And we don't have to just leave it as it is and do the spiritual warfare in any way, anyhow. No. Let's be serious, focus it. When you are ready to do spiritual battle, just focus and then do it and do it well. The next thing I want to say is that you do this wrestling with sensitivity. You must learn to be sensitive to God or the Spirit of God. What I mean is that when you are praying, sometimes God will direct you. You don't just say, and you are just going. You don't just only speak in tongues and you are going. Be sensitive to God, because as you're speaking, God will touch your heart. He will direct you, or he will instruct you, or he will show you something. He will just give you an idea how to do that battle. Sometimes even that spiritual battle we think is so just praying. Sometimes God will just give you one idea and everything is okay with you. So learn to be sensitive when you are wrestling in the realm of the spirit. The next thing I want to say, which may be the final point for this, is that determination. You learn to determine that this battle I will go through and I will finish. Determination will take you through the battle, and God will make sure at the end of it all, you win the battle. So we don't just say that, well, we need to just pray, but then I am tired, I can't go on. This is too much for me. No, if you study today, you are not able to win or you are not able to finish it, do it another day. Continue and persistently, God will help you and you will overcome. What I want to say is that when you stop wrestling with principalities and powers, you will wrestle with flesh and blood. That is how it is. In other words, you learn to pray, win the battle in the spirit. When you win the battle in the spirit, flesh and blood will become nothing. If you don't learn to win battle in the spirit, and you don't want to wrestle in the spirit and win the battle, then by the time you realize you are wrestling with flesh and blood, men and women will wrestle with you. You will see that everything you are doing, anytime you are struggling and you are wrestling with flesh and blood, you will wrestle with flesh and blood. Little thing, then you are irritated. Little thing, you are irritated. Things are not working well for you and you do not understand. You think it's somebody sitting somewhere, because you have no idea what is going on and you can't even stand and do this battle. You learn to do this battle so that you win it in the spirit. Don't do it only in the flesh. Win it in the spirit. When you win it in the spirit, you win also in the physical, because that is what it's all about. Christianity is not just simple, like flesh and everything is flesh and flesh. No, Christianity is also spiritual, because God is a spirit And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Remember, God is a spirit. How do you communicate with God? That is why he gave us his spirit, so that we can communicate with him. And demons and spiritual things, principalities and powers and whatever they are, they also operate in the realm of the spirit. That is why you don't just give up. You learn to be strong and learn to win your battles in the spirit. And when you win it, then physically, you will also win that battle. I pray that God will help you. He will teach you. He will arm you. He will strengthen your hands. Teach you how to do every battle that comes your way. Those that you sense in your spirit, you yourself, sometimes you sense this one, it is of a spiritual battle. Don't be afraid of that. Go to God in prayer. Ask him to strengthen you. He will strengthen you. He will arm you. And when he arms you, make sure you don't take the ammunition and the tools and sit down. Face the enemy, engage him in a battle, and you will win. Because with God, all things are possible. And he is always ready to make us win in any spiritual battle that we go through. May the Lord help you. May he grant you the grace. May he strengthen you spiritually. May any battle that you are going through spiritually, be it from home, wherever it's coming from, office, wherever it is, I pray that the grace of God will abound upon you. I pray and I stand with you in the realm of the spirit and do battle with you in the name of Jesus. I break that power. I break that demonic influence. I break that influence that want to suppress you. I break that spirit that is behind that thing in the mighty name of Jesus. And I ask that your hand will be strong. I speak upon your life that you will go through it. You will overcome it. Don't give up yet, and you will not give up, because victory is yours. May the Lord's name be great upon your life, and may you have a testimony as you go through this time in the mighty name of Jesus. And everything that God has said concerning you will surely come to pass. I bless you with the blessing of the Lord, and I ask his spirit to energize you, that your spirit man will be strong in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.